You cannot run looking behind you. You cannot. They would tell us to fix your sight on a point out there ahead and just stay with it. Stay with it. Guess what? He tells us what to fix our eyes on. There's a point out there. It's not here. It's not your marriage. It's not your kids. It's not your circumstances. It's not your health. Looking unto, say it, Jesus. Because in the Greek, there were multiple words for see or look. The normal word is just blepo. Look at that. This is a word he chose to use, aphoreo, that literally means to turn away from one thing you've been looking at, to intentionally fix your gaze on something else instead. Before you come to faith in Christ, most of us have had our eyes fixed on something else. We're creatures who want to fixate on something. We want to make much of something. So he realizes whatever you've been making much of prior to Christ, it will not be automatic. You'll keep doing that if you're not careful. So he says, don't turn away from that to look at this instead. Looking unto Jesus, which again, I want you to bring into focus here. This series is not just about killing idols. It's about cultivating intimacy with Christ. You only know who you look at a lot and who you listen to and who you spend time with, who you fixate on. That's who you begin to know. And guess what? You become more like them. Who you hanging out with, you're going to become like them. Who you listening to, you'll become like them. Who do you look to constantly? You will become like them. He's like, looking unto Jesus. This is not a stick your head in the sand. I've got to look at other things in this world. But I tell you what, I start each day by looking to Jesus. If you're wondering, how would I obey that verse? By spending time in God's word, sitting quiet with your Savior in the morning, I'm going to look to Jesus again. I'm going to look to Jesus again. Because notice this, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Some of you are believers and you started with Jesus. You're like, hallelujah, there's a Savior. He forgave me. You started with Jesus, but you've moved on to something else. You can't do that. You start with Jesus and you got to stay with Jesus. Stay, keep him the main thing. Keep him at the center. Keep him in view. Let him be the grid through which you see your circumstances and world.